It's Friday, and that means it's time for Black Friday Follies. Yes, toxic masculinity in art, what to avoid on Black Friday. It's almost over, but, and John Voight helps Raymond's couture. Joining us with all the very important details is Raymond Arroyo, Fox News contributor. Raymond, I thought we were done with this whole toxic masculinity issue, but now apparently it's making its debut at a museum?
Yes,
what's happening?
The Baltimore Museum of Art has announced that next year it will only be purchasing art created by women. Forget Rodin, Singer Sargent, Michelangelo, Renoir, out with them. Here's how the museum director, Christopher Bedford, explains the decision. He writes, I would say the 2020 vision is just an extension of the code of ethics that have been deeply embedded within the museum. Building a permanent collection is building a story for all time. A story, apparently, Laura, without men. I mean, how do you help women by exempting men from the museum? This is crazy.
Maybe I should just do an entire show with just women.
Right.
And just see. Just imagine if I just announced that.
Well,
what is this? I mean, they're supposed to, everyone's supposed to be just judged on their own merits, on
right.
their own value, make their own choices. And now you are actually having your worth determined by the sex that you were born with. How does that make any sense?
Well, one of the artists, Laura, Elisa Blout Moorhead, who will be featured in the Baltimore Museum of Art, she has great hopes for this gender-exclusive approach. She says, I'm hoping that all of us can start to think about how patriarchy and hierarchy has really diminished people's interest in museums and cultural centers. This will enliven the audience. It's just the right thing to do.
Well,
this is the wrong thing to do. The right thing to do is to let art stand on its own and let people judge what is worthy or not worthy for inclusion based on how it looks and what audience it can draw, not by who painted
it, Raymond,
or what plumbing they had.
Raymond,
at the time.
Back in college, in my college newspaper, we would rip the whole idea of studies. Like, you put women in history and in literature and African Americans in history and literature, but now everything is studies. Every group has a studies.
Yeah, well,
and women's studies, et cetera. And I just think it balkanizes people.
Exactly.
It segregates them.
Exactly.
I don't like it.
And it segregates thought, which is crazy.
Right. I will say that Raymond has a tendency of doing, like, he's usually sitting right here next to me when he's doing his segments, but he has been known to take his iPhone out and adjust his tie.
I also do that.
Check the lights for various parts of his head that might be shiny. So I was told by the producers that when you sat down with Voight the other day, John Voight, there was a moment. Let's watch.
Can I stand or no?
Do you need to stand?
I don't know. I was going to grab him, but I was going to fix his tie. Push the damn thing over, will you?
Which way?
That's it.
There?
That's push it all the way over there. Now, you got to do it yourself. Way over to the left. Okay. Way over to the left.
You never go to the left, John. Why are you making me?
Is this what I came to see?
Better
you've
got
to
interview.
Push it that way.
I know.
Way
I'm
over.
Trying. I'm trying. Look, I'm using.
No, you're not doing it. Now, now pull it tight. Now, pull it tight.
Okay.
Now,
there
pull
we go.
It tight. You got it.
That's it. Okay. He fixed it. But I do need powder. Now I'm sweating. Laura.
You are so punked. We totally got you.
This went on for 5 minutes. With silk ties, they move on you. If you don't tie a Windsor knot, they move. You have to adjust them. And John got a little frustrated, and he's a great pal. So he was willing to help me out.
I have a question. Is this the first time you've attempted to knot the cravat? Okay, what was that? You don't know how to knot your own tie? This is like I'm dealing with Dimitri or Nico, my son.
But this is the first time I've had an Academy Award winner help me adjust the tie.
So, you planned that.
I did not. Ingram, this is a great Christmas tip for you. You could get me clip-on ties that don't move. This is
I have
idea.
Those. My sons have that for their school because they have to wear a tie
I know. They
and
wear
a shirt
the tie
every day.
With the jacket.
Yeah, they have that tie with the little expand-a-band behind, so you just throw it. They just, like, have it hanging over their necks, and then they go zzz, and it has a little zip feature. It's awesome.
You should get me a clip-on tie. I'm going to get you some earrings that go over the ears as a backup.
I'm going to tell the story about the the earrings at some point, but this is the longest tease ever of why the earrings always fall out. But we have too much shopping anticipation building up in the show tonight, so I don't think we can do. We can't discuss that. That's just too much excitement in one show.
You can't do it all.
All right, Raymond, have a good weekend. Great to see you.